marriages, I think what they're saying is they want the right to be legally recognized for their covenant with each other in a monogamous relationship.
Absolutely.
And so what I see is basically heterosexual relationships, be they married or not, mm-hmm. celebrated in church, no matter if the person falls from grace or is pregnant, it's still straight. Mm. So God honors straight sin over gay commitment.
Well,
gay sin.
This is nothing new. I mean, the church has always put a hierarchy on sin. Mm-hmm. You know, if you fornicate, yeah, we'll talk about it, mm-hmm. but that's at least better than being gay.
Gay. Yeah.
And that's always been the case. So let's not act brand new.
No.
That we've always done that. It's a bit hypocritical, but we've always done it.
Right. I don't believe that the sin is sex. The sin is fornication. If you are sleeping with multiple people or not in a committed relationship before God with that person, I believe that God is not happy with promiscuity on any front.
On any level.
Yeah, I believe He's a covenant making and covenant bearing God. So for me to say that because someone is attracted to the same sex that they are now a devil would be to say, I'm saying that God has already brought judgment on someone who basically can't help the way that they may feel.
Can you help the way that you feel?
I've tried.
So what's your conclusion that you
My
are?
My conclusion is I'm waiting to see what God wants to do. Because I don't know who He's allowing me to experience this walk of life to minister to later on. The church has completely faggotized everybody who's gay, sends them to hell over the pulpit, and the church literally screams hooray and are happy about that. And yet we celebrate the pastor who has a clean record and a clean look, but yet he's still doing the same thing that the same gender-loving people are doing, but yet he has the look. And so I feel that that's a community that has kept gospel alive. They're within the gospel community. They are human beings. And I believe that God loves everybody. And I believe that there are Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized, gay people.
You're waiting to see what God is going to do in your life. So are you waiting for deliverance from being attracted to men?
I'm not sure that's something I have to be delivered from.
You're not sure?
Yeah. Because you know why?
Certain but you're pastoring.
Yeah.
So shouldn't you be sure of?
No, because I'm in a walk just like them. I mean, the pastoring is me being the under-shepherd, pointing them to the cross, not to Tonex. It's me preaching the unadulterated word of God towards repentance and cross. I don't get in people's bedroom.
Gotcha.
I don't get in people's clothes closets about their fashion choices or their makeup drawers. God's not looking at that. The posture of their heart is the most important thing. And for me to point them to the cross is the most important thing because I need that cross too.
Yeah, I do too.
And so before I say, this is what I am, this is the only thing I'll be, I'll say at this stage, this is what it is. So everyone can just breathe and relax on your show and say, Tonex said, yes, he's attracted to men. Yes, he has experienced gay sex before, but that's the least of who this man of God is. There's so many people that are waiting for somebody to just say, God, I'm not crazy. There are so many people holding stuff in, pretending this life of whatever it may be, just because they're afraid of what people will do to them. And I'm saying, go to the cross. I've tried. I've been through deliverance services and had oil slung all over me. Come out. You foul spirit of homosexuality. Leave him now in the name of Jesus. When it should have been, you foul spirit of lust, maybe. Or envy. Or pride. It's the lust of the eye. It didn't say lust straight or gay. It said lust of the eye, lust of the flesh, pride of life. Those were the key issues I needed deliverance from. Now, as far as like which way I'm going, I'm being open today and saying where I'm at now. I didn't have to do that, but I just want to be honest. People could say, see, I knew it all along. Well, if you knew it all along, this is the same guy who was taking you into the presence of the Lord. This is the same guy that wrote those songs. I'm no different. That side of me is not the core of who I am. And I said, Lord, if you gave me these gifts and I have this cross to bear, take this thing out. I don't want it. He hasn't done it yet. I'm banking on the fact that his grace is sufficient and that he knows the end of this better than I do.
If you died right now, would you go to heaven?
Yes, because I told the truth. A liar shall not tarry in his sight. This is a struggle for people to feel free enough to confess your faults, share your testimony, that you continue to love me and just love me because I love you. My walk is a testament of God's grace and favor. Because he could have killed me while I was trying to hide everything. You know, I'm just banking on the fact that he told me, ye shall know the truth and the truth will make you free. I'm just standing on God's word in the sense of either I tell the truth or I might as well just shut up for the rest of my life. I'm not that dude. I'm not that dude. I'm never gonna stop preaching. I'm not leaving church. I'm not turning my back on God. I love God, I love my family. I'm not here to hurt, I'm here to help. And I'm not here to turn the world gay. I'm not here to bash anybody who's straight. I'm not here to applaud anything that God would not be pleased with in any area of life. I'm here saying this is my life, here's my cards. This is where it's at. Now, you can either pause here and judge, or you can keep watching to see, because you never know. God has a way of turning things around and revealing things that he works in a way we don't understand. So watch and pray. That's all I can say. And thanks for everybody who prayed for me, emailed me. If I hurt anyone or let anyone down as a result of my transparency, I'm sorry that it hurt you, but it helped me. I feel much better. And I hope that you continue to love me and just love me, because I love you.
I would like to take this time to thank my friend and brother Tonex for a very open, honest, and candid interview. It is my belief that a man is made for a woman, and a woman is made for a man. I believe that the Bible speaks very clearly about this. However, as a journalist, it is my job to tell the story. And as a Christian, it is my job to love absolutely everybody, and I do that unequivocally and unapologetically. So until next time.